This is astonishing. Have a listen to this.
Oh, today I prefer to speak Italian, first of all, because I want to send a message to my players, and I want my message to be very clear.
Extremely angry, very angry indeed, because this defeat was due to our mentality more than anything else, our mental approach, because we played against a team which mentally was far more determined than we were, and this is something which I can't accept. It seems to me that as a group of players, they're not particularly aggressive from a mental point of view. They don't have that kind of ferocity in their mentality. And that's something which I think is down to the type of players they are, their characteristics. And it's something which is difficult to change because you have to try to influence their mentality. And it's something which could take quite a long time. By the same token, it could be changed by a new player coming in, or perhaps one of the old heads in the team, assuming responsibility and driving the rest of the team forward.
Wow. I mean, this could be a critical moment in his time in charge of Chelsea, because this is either going to work or it is spectacularly not going to work. Because, you know, we've seen this before at this very football club numerous times, and the manager never wins these battles at
Chelsea. This is a huge, huge gamble from Sarri's point of view. He's looking for a response, and rightly so. Doing it publicly in a presser after a game, it's questionable because, as you said, these players have been through this with a couple of managers and the managers get gone.
I mean, everything at Chelsea is short-term, really, except for the players. So he's gone to war with the players now. And is he going to survive this? And he's talking about mentality and the hunger of the team. It's going to have to work because they'll just change the manager. They won't change the players. This group of players has survived quite a few managers. They've been to a degree of success there, you have to say. But at the moment, the wheels are coming off, and he's really put it out. He's blaming the players. Mm. He's digging the players out. It's over to them. Are they going to perform? Are they going to improve things on the pitch? If it doesn't improve, then they might look to change the manager.
Have you ever been in a position where a manager does this and it actually works? It's effective. The players come out in 7 days' time and deliver for you.
I don't really get the public one.
No.
I really don't, because whatever can be said, you know, if he wants to get hold of me, have a scrap, tell me to my face that I'm a disgrace and I'm not doing what I should be doing on the pitch, I'll accept that and that's fine, you know, and I'll go and have a look at myself and address that in training, you know, come Monday morning. I don't get the whole coming out to the public and going down that road. As Rio said, it's a massive gamble. I think he's protecting himself. That's one part of it that I don't like, because you're very much going you. Well, where's the collective team thing within all that? You know, you win together, you lose together. It's a simple thing. Now, everything that's happening on that pitch is, they're his team. He's preparing them all week. There's a reason why they're on that pitch in that mood. So he has to assume some responsibility himself. So whatever he's saying in that press conference, he needs to put on his own head as well. And that's what I've never liked about that public disgracing. I think he's right, by the way, but say it in the dressing room.
Yeah, I think he's right in the first half. I think in the first half, they didn't start the game, and that's why they lost the match. I saw a reaction. I wouldn't say they've lost the players. The likes of Alonso, fullbacks both getting forward. They just didn't have the quality to put the ball in the back of the net. They didn't have the structure to do that, and he's at fault for the structure as much as the players. Mm. So it's not his them and us situation. That's what he's trying to make it.
That's the
damage now. He'd be collecting, coming back to the situation, and who are going to be the runners and riders that he can rely upon now to get them out.
I just think of it, if I was a player in that changer, if he'd come out and he'd hammered the players and said, but on the other hand as well, I'm getting a few things wrong, but I'm going to address my mistakes and I'm going to get them wrong. Mm. I think he'd have had everyone in that change room onside and they'd all go, you know what? He's right.
This is all about their need to adapt and not his need to adapt.
No, but we spoke about it straight after the game in our after-match analysis. Tactically, there's a few things not right in this team, and two basic things are two players, his best players, playing in wrong positions, Kante and Hazard at the moment. So that's on him. That's down to him to address that. And if he took some form of responsibility publicly before that rant, I think he'd have a chance.
It's interesting how he didn't want to say it himself. Maybe they sat the interpreter. I didn't say it. He didn't say what I meant.
You know what's also interesting here is that, you know, Jermaine's come out and said the public one is an issue for me. Do it privately. This doesn't seem like the actions of a manager who was totally happy with his Chelsea squad and everything was fine until today and now he's gone. It's almost like he's had those private conversations maybe. This has been bubbling under the surface in those recent games where they haven't performed properly and now finally he snapped and he thought, if I do this privately and you don't react, I'm going to have to do this publicly. It's kind of the act of a desperate manager, isn't it?
Yeah, well, he's obviously been pushed into a corner because he's seen this team, they've been struggling to score goals. They've had some inconsistent performances as well in amongst that. And so, yeah, I'm sure behind closed doors, he doesn't look like a shrinking violet. He doesn't look like someone who walk in the change room and wouldn't say a word. He looks like someone who will shout the house down and get in people's faces. So
He's at the end of a 7-day period, isn't he? We talked about Emery, and it's almost like, well, let's see who's the best coach then. And where were we before today started? And he's that body of work, he's done 7 days, they haven't really responded to him. They're not... The message is at the beginning of the season, yes, but they're not really having him. They're not buying into it. He senses it. He smells it. And he's gone for broke. And he's attacked the players. And I think it's a huge gamble. It's a huge... I think he'll ride out the storm and I don't think Chelsea will sack him. But there's that fourth place now. Everyone says, you know, you're playing for to win the Premier League. But Manchester United, Arsenal, Chelsea, all going for that one position. Mm. And you look at it now, who's best place to do that? It doesn't seem there's a stability there at Chelsea to carry that through at the moment. It's huge.
I look at today and you see Kante, who's been one of the best players in the Premier League for the last couple of years. Even him, someone as pure as him, his body language today wasn't the Kante that we've all seen.
Yeah.
He didn't have that spark and that bounce in him that he normally has. And that's a player there who I'm sure is sitting there saying, I've done nothing to be pushed out of my position. I'm the best. I'm one of the best. A humble human being he is. He would sit there as a professional and say, I'm the best in that position. Why aren't I playing there?
They've stopped believing in the manager. Rudiger and David Luiz, we were saying, who sat here, who's marking the box? Mm. Ball goes out wide. You get back as quick as you can. You try to pick up. You recover. Rudiger wasn't doing that at all. It's almost as if people have stopped doing the basics. And that can happen when somebody's so dictatorial on the training pitch that you then don't become the leaders when you go onto the pitch on a match day, because it's down to the players. You've got to develop leaders that take ownership of their own careers. There's no time to lose.
It's cure to everything as well at the minute. It seems to be just a buy. Because in the presser there, he's saying, you know, there's only a couple of things that are going to change. I either go and buy a new player or I get an experienced player. Now, you've already complained about your strikers and ran their confidence through the floor. So what are you going to do? Right, you've been given Higuain. And now you're questioning the mentality of the team. So what are you going to do? What are you going to go and, I don't know, buy Verratti or buy... a commander in
there.
They're
a buying club, and though, aren't they?
Yes, since Abramovich. At what point do you start coaching your team to have that mentality? This team has won, like, 2 league titles in, what, the last 4 years or something?
Yeah.
The mentality is there. The players have it within them to do it. So that's why I say... it's a collective thing. You're all in the same boat together. Managers, coaches, goalkeeping staff, like, just sing off the same hymn sheet. This just creates a divide for me.
Is he still being assisted in the transfer market in the way that previous managers were? They've spent £1.5 billion since Abramovich has been at that football club. Contrast that with Arsenal, who's spent half of that. You think about every one of those 5 Premier League trophies they've won has really cost them £1.5 million. £150 million to win those trophies. It's an hell of a lot of money. Nice. And this manager's looking at it and saying to himself,
"Yeah,
where's my cash injection?"
He's just done £60 million on Pulisic, by the way.
Yes, I know, but he's
getting Higuain.
He wants a centre forward.
No, but they're addressing that now, though.
Yeah,
well, maybe
he wants to change the whole
Ross
lot.
Barkley.
Maybe there's the fabric of this team that he wants to change right the way through. Because the nucleus of these players have been there a long time.
Well, Abramovich doesn't seem like a man who's got patience. No. He's not someone who's patient with his managers.
Chelsea under Abramovich, though, has not been built on patience, has it? It's been built on the quick fix and winning trophies.
I don't think money and being backed is the issue. I think he's had money to spend. You've got when he first came, coaching wasn't an issue because he straight away you saw his identity through this team immediately. It's about having been able to be flexible and being adaptable in this league.
Can you imagine that conversation? There's a new manager coming in and you're a Roman and you say, well, you know, what do you want then? And he goes, well, I need a holding midfield player. You wouldn't know what to say, would you? You'd be like, have you not seen N'Golo Kanté, yeah. you know, and what he's been doing for the last couple of years? But he still gave him the money to go, go on then, go. I'll give you what you want.
We've got to take a break, but there's only one thing I really want to know. Just tell me, what will that be happening now among the Chelsea players? How do players react to this?
The WhatsApp groups have begun bananas. Have you seen that? Get on this. The links will be being sent through the WhatsApp groups. Yeah. Get on this, and then there'll be comments going on, and then they'll abort the WhatsApp group.
Getting it as well.
They'll all abort the WhatsApp group after that.
Is that what happened?
That happened, yeah.
You sound like you've got experience in this area.
I've seen it. I weren't involved, but I saw it.